We'll start our session. Right. So, once again, good morning, everyone. Welcome to yet another online tutorial on principles of communication system. So, we are into module two. We started with some of the basics of angle modulation yesterday. Right. So, today we'll continue with our discussion and we'll elaborate some of the properties which I've just mentioned. Right. I mentioned some five properties of angle modulation. So, we'll elaborate those properties. Right, and we'll try to simulate and see what actually is FM. Even though I have mentioned PM and FM simulation, we'll concentrate on FM simulation, and we'll try to see what actually is FM with respect to message, how the modulated signal is actually what varying. That part we'll try and concentrate. So we'll straight away start with the properties. Yesterday we have seen what are the properties, right? So the properties were constancy of transmitted power, right? Non-linearity of modulation process, irregularity of zero crossings, visualization difficulty of message waveform, trade off of increased transmission bandwidth for improved noise. So I don't know whether in exam they'll be asking this, whether they ask or not, these important properties we should have a clear idea, right? So now what we'll do is we'll take these properties one by one and inspect. So first we'll take about the constancy of transmitted power. So from the wave itself, we can see whether it is PM or FM, the amplitude envelope is constant. So amplitude envelope is constant, right? It is equal to AC only. It is equal to AC only. Of course, the zero crossing time or instantaneous frequency or phase is changing, but amplitude is constant, right? So in while discussing first module itself, we told if right AC is the peak amplitude of a sinusoid, right? If AC is the peak amplitude of a sinusoid, what is the power delivered to a 1 ohm resistor? Anyone remember? Power delivered to a 1 ohm resistor? We know it is actually what? If AC is peak amplitude, AC by root 2 will be actually RMS amplitude or RMS voltage, right? So square of this, right? Square of this divided by R, right? Divided by R. This will be average power delivered to 1 ohm resistor. So we have assumed R to be equal to 1. So then what we got is it was equal to AC square by 2, right? So for any sinusoid, just keep in mind, irrespective of the frequency or phase, right? Any sinusoid whose peak amplitude is equal to AC, the average power delivered to a 1 ohm resistor is AC square by 2. This is something which we already know, right? Now we'll see what actually will be the average power, right, of FM and PM, right? So amplitude envelopes of FM and PM are constant, and we have seen it is equal to AC. It's not going to change, only zero crossing time is changing, right? And this is constant irrespective of the message signal and the sensitivity factor. So we have M of T, whatever be the M of T, whatever be the sensitivity factor, right? Message amplitude envelope will be a constant, right? So then can anyone tell me what will be the average transmitted power of FM and PM? It will be equal to, right, if we assume R equal to 1 ohm, if we assume R equal to 1 ohm, P average will be equal to half AC square, right? Just you have to just remember this, right? P average will be equal to half AC square. Average power is a constant. So as envelope is constant, average power is a constant. So this is quite straightforward. So right, that is about constancy of transmitted power. So whereas in AM, if you remember, amplitude is changing. So as instantaneous amplitude is changing, instantaneous power will change, right? Then average power will not be a constant, right? Average power over any given time interval won't be constant. But here, if any given time interval you take, average power will be a constant. So that is about constancy of transmitted power, right? Next, we have to see what is meant by non-linearity of modulation process, right? So both PM and FM waves are non-linear. Why? Because they violate superposition principle. So if I say something is linear, right? If I say, right, a system is linear, it should follow two conditions. One is superposition. Another one is homogeneity, right? So it should follow, it should be, it should follow homogeneity and it should follow superposition, right? So it violates superposition principle itself. So we, how we'll, for that we can, we'll consider, right, the message signal is m of t. We'll consider the message signal as m of t, right? And it, and that m of t is made up of two different components, m1 of t and m2 of t. We'll assume a message signal m of t is made up of two different components, m1 of t and m2 of t. We have seen such cases while solving amplitude modulation problems. It has frequency contents 100, 200, 400, 600, right? So we have assumed the message signal to be what? Cos 2 pi 100 t plus cos 2 pi 400 t plus so on and so forth we considered, right? Then we modulated, right? So in AM we did that, but in FM will it work? If we have right m of t, which is, which has two components, m1 of t and m2 of t, right? So now if you frequency modulate a carrier with m of t, right, initially you are trying to frequency modulate a carrier with m of t so that you will get s of t, right? If you frequency modulate a carrier with m of t, you will be getting s of t. And if you are modulating with m1 of t, the resultant modulated signal will be s1 of t. And if you are modulating with m2 of t, the resultant modulated signal will be s2 of t, right? Now, right, so what will be s of t? S of t is nothing but what? This m of t modulating a carrier. So we can write it a frequency more, if it, if you assume phase modulation, the same will apply for frequency modulation also. If you assume phase modulation, s of t will be equal to ac cos 2 pi fct plus kp into m of t, right? This entire thing is m of t, right? So this is s of t. Now what will be s1 of t? S1 of t will be equal to ac cos 2 pi fct kp into m1 of t, right? S1 of t is considering only m1 of t as modulated signal, right? And s2 of t is considering only m2 of t as modulated signal. Now my question is whether s of t is equal to s1 of t plus s2 of t. Whether s of t is equal to s1 of t plus s2 of t. The answer is no. Maybe you can verify it, right? Of course, AC cos 2 pi FCT plus KP into M1 of T plus M2 of T is not equal to AC cos 2 pi FCT plus KP into M1 of T plus AC cos 2 pi FCT into KT into M2 of T, right? So it's, so it, it is not following superposition condition. So it is, it is actually what? It is non-linear, right? Frequency modulation, it is non-linear. Why? Because it violates superposition condition. Same thing is applicable for actually what? FM also. You can try it out. Right, so FM is, FM and PM, angle modulation in general is non-linear, and because of this non-linearity, right, we do have some practical benefits, right? Because of this non-linearity, the envelope is constant, but zero crossing time is different, right? But one difficulty is the complexity is more, right? So complexity is more because of this non-linearity, right? Complexity of FM modulator and demodulator will be more, but right, it offers actually what? Superior noise performance. That superior noise performance is a result of this non-linearity, right? Whereas amplitude modulation, it is a linear process, but angle modulation, it is a non-linear process. Why? Because it doesn't follow superposition, right? So that is about non-linearity. So please do note down these things. At the end, I may, right, ask a question from these things. Right. Okay. So any doubt on this non-linearity? I hope it's pretty much clear. No? Right. Next, we will see about irregular zero crossing. So for that, we'll just go back and visit our FM and PM signal. So this is phase modulated signal and this is frequency modulated signal. You can see, and this is AM signal. AM signal we have seen yesterday, zero crossing, it happens at actually what? Regular intervals. Zero crossing means the instance at which actually what? The amplitude changes from positive to negative or from negative to positive. That is actually called zero crossing. For AM, the zero crossing interval is a constant, right? It is regular, it repeats in a regular interval, and that will be equal to what? Half the carrier time period. It will be half the carrier time period. But whereas in PM or FM, you can see it's irregular. It's irregular. Why? Because the instantaneous phase or frequency is changing. So because of that, zero crossing also is changing. And we can tell the information, right? If information of AM lies in envelope, if I can say information of AM is lying within envelope, right? But information of AM, FM and PM, it lies in the zero crossings. Please make a note of it, right? Information of FM and PM, it lies actually in the zero crossings. This interval between zero crossings is what is changing with respect to the message signal. Right. Now, while simulating, we'll just try and see if we can relate this. Right. Maybe we will not see PM in detail. Right. We'll see FM. So, can you see any relation between amplitude and the frequency of the modulated wave? Maybe if you see here, if amplitude is more, you can see frequency is more. Right. Wherever amplitude is less, amplitude is negative, frequency is less. Right. So, there is a correspondence, right, between amplitude and frequency. Right. Whereas in PM, we can't even see that, right? It's right. Maybe we'll see while simulating. We'll see, right? What exactly is that, right? So now, irregular zero crossing, a consequence of allowing the instantaneous angle to become actually what in dependent on message. So we have seen in PM, theta is actually what proportional to m of t. Theta is proportional to m of t. Whereas in FM, theta is proportional to actually what? Integral of m of t, right? So instantaneous angle, it is either proportional to m of t or integral of m of t, right? So as a consequence, right, zero crossing of a PM or FM wave no longer have a perfect regularity in the spacing across the time scale, right? So, as I mentioned, zero crossings are defined as the instance of time at which waveform changes its amplitude from positive to negative or the other way around, right? So, in a way, the irregularity of zero crossings in angle modulated waves is also attributed to the nonlinear. So, this is also actually what it can be because of this nonlinear character. It is because of this nonlinear characteristics, right? It can be related to the nonlinear characteristics, right? And as I mentioned, in angle modulation, information content resides in zero crossing. That is very important point which you have to keep in mind, right? Information contents resides within zero crossing. Now, what we'll do is we'll try and solve a problem, right? Maybe we can expect this problem for exam, right? It was not asked before. Maybe it can be asked, right? It can be asked. It can be a question, right? So, this is the problem. Maybe all of you please note it down. Right, consider a modulating wave m of t that increases linearly with time t starting at t equal to 0. Right, so m of t is given like this. M of t is equal to a t for t greater than 0 and 0 for t less than 0. So maybe we'll try and draw what is m of t. Right, so this is t and say this is m of t. Right, y axis is m of t. For t less than 0, m of t is equal to 0. So t less than 0, m of t is equal to 0, fine, right? And for t greater than 0, m of t is equal to at. At means with a constant slope, right? A will be the slope, right? So m of t is equal to at. For t greater than 0, m of t is equal to at, where a will be nothing but what? It's slope of this, right? If a is more, it will be very steep. If A is very low, it will be what? Very slant, right? So that is actually, consider this is our message signal, right? So you can see the message signal amplitude is increasing linearly, right? At time t equal to infinity, the amplitude will become infinity, right? So now we can see what happens to the instantaneous phase or instantaneous frequency with respect to amplitude. So now the question is, right? It's given A is a slope parameter. So find the zero crossing times for PM and FM for the following parameter. So parameters are given, right? So carrier frequency FC is equal to 1 by 4 hertz, right? A is equal to 1 volt per second. Phase sensitivity factor of PM is pi by 2 radians per volts. So what will be the okay, maybe we'll see the unit of phase sensitivity is radians per volt, right? So please keep in mind, and frequency sensitivity factor of FM is equal to 1 hertz per volt. Now we should find the zero crossing instance. This can be a question in your university exam. So we'll try and solve this. All of you, please note down this problem, right? So now I'll just move to the whiteboard part, right? So you have to just help me out, right? So what is given M of T, all of you, okay, one second, I'll just share this white screen, whiteboard, give me a moment, right? I'll just, I'll just stop sharing this and I'll share a can anyone tell me whether the screen is visible now? Whiteboard is visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So what is all of you have noted down the problem, or should I show the problem once again?
Yes, sir. Can you show the problem?
I'll show the problem once again. Right. So please note it down. I'll just stop this sharing and I'll just, yeah. Please note down the problem initially, then we'll solve it. Should I read it out? So consider a modulating wave M of T that increases linearly with time T, starting at T equal to 0. M of T is given as AT for T greater than 0, 0 for T less than or equal to 0, where A is a slope parameter. So find the zero crossing times for PM and FM for the following parameters. All of you, please note down. Right. Carrier frequency FC is equal to 1 by 4 hertz. A is equal to 1 volts per second. Phase sensitivity factor for phase modulation, that is KP, is equal to pi by 2 radians per volt. Frequency sensitivity factor for FM, that is KF, is equal to 1 hertz per volt. These are given. So what we need to find is, we need to find the zero crossing times. Zero crossing time, in the sense, I just listen, see here, at which instances, right, FM and PM will have zero crossings. T, if this is time axis, so at what time instances there will be zero crossings? That is what we have to find, right? T at which we will have zero crossings. That is what we have to find, right? So now, all of you have noted down the problem. Shall I move on to? Shall we move ahead and solve this? Please, someone, please confirm. Pratiksha.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, noted down. At least one I have noted down.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay. Fine. So now we'll move ahead and solve this problem. Right. So before that, I'll just share the white screen. Yeah. So now what we have is M of T is equal to AT for T greater than 0 and 0 for T less than or equal to 0, right? So we have plotted it like this. M of T is something like this. It is 0 for T less than 0 and 80 for T greater than 0. This is T and this is m of t. Right. So this is what is our m of t. Then what else is given? Fc is 1 by 4 hertz. Right. Fc is 1 by 4 hertz. And let us also assume AC is equal to 1 volt. Right. Let us also assume AC is equal to 1 volt. So what will be C of t? Carrier signal C of t will be AC cos 2 pi FCT. Right. So then what else is given? We'll note down. This A is given to be equal to 1 volt per second, right? A is 1 volt per second. Then KP, what was KP? Phase sensitivity of phase modulator. It was pi by 2 radians per volt, right? Pi by 2 radians per volt, right? And KF was 1 hertz per volt, right? So these are given. So now what we'll do is we'll just try and write down the expression of phase modulation first. So what will be time domain expression of phase modulation, right? We have seen it yesterday. We can call it S of t is equal to, right, AC cos, it is 2 pi FCT plus KP into M of t. This is our S of t, right? So now we know this is equal to, right, S of t will be equal to, for t greater than 0, it is equal to AT. For t less than 0, M of t equal to 0. So if I substitute that, for t, S of t will be equal to AC cos 2 pi FCT plus KP into AT. I'm not substituting the values here now, right? Values of A, FC, all those things we'll substitute at the end, right? Let it be like this now, right? So AC cos 2 pi FCT plus KP into AT, that is what is S of T for T greater than 0. And this is equal to AC cos 2 pi FCT for T less than or equal to 0. In fact, actually what the modulation, right, happens after T greater than 0, right? After T greater than 0, the modulation happens. So now we need to see, right, when this AC cos 2 pi FCT plus KP into AT, this will be equal to 0, right? We need to find value of T, right, value of T for which S of T is equal to 0, right? Value of T for which S of T is equal to 0. So S of T is actually what? AC cos 2 pi FCT plus KP into AT. This should be equal to 0, right? So this is cos of something, right? Cosine of something, right? Cosine of something. So when cosine of something will be equal to 0, we know cos of 0 is 1, but cos of pi by 2 is equal to 0. In fact, odd multiples of pi by 2, right? For all odd multiples of pi by 2, cos of something will be equal to 0. So this happens when, so this is equal to 0, which implies I can write 2 pi FCT plus KP into AT. This should be equal to odd multiples of pi by 2. This should be odd multiples of pi by 2, right? This thing should be odd multiples of pi by 2. Then cos of something will be equal to 0. So that is, how can I write it mathematically? It should be equal to, right, odd multiples of pi by 2. I can either write it as actually what? Pi by 2 plus pi, right? Pi by 2 plus n pi, right? Pi by 2 plus n, or else, right? I can write it as, Right. 2 n plus 1 times pi by 2, where n will be equal to what? 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. You might have seen this in many places. So the condition is 2 pi fct plus kp into at should be 2 n plus 1 pi by 2. Right. So this is nothing but what, or in other words, if I can simplify it, it will be equal to what? 2 n pi by 2. This is n, plus pi by 2. Right. 2 n pi by 2 plus pi by 2, which means it is equal to what? N pi plus pi by 2. So what we need to solve is, we need to solve for this t. Right. I'll write it here. So 2 pi fc t plus kp into a into t, this is equal to n pi plus pi by 2. Right. So for, we need to solve for this t, we need to find the value of t which satisfies this equation. This is a linear equation, first order equation. Right. First order equation. How to solve this? How to solve for this? Right. So maybe t, if I take common, I'll get 2 pi fc plus kp into a, 2 pi fc plus kp into a times t is equal to n pi plus pi by 2. Right. N pi plus pi by 2 we will get. Right. So now we have to solve for this t. What will be this t? This t will be equal to n pi plus pi by 2 divided by 2 pi fc plus kp into a. Right. Whenever, right, where n is equal to what? 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. Right. So now what we'll do is we'll try and substitute the values. Right. We'll try and substitute the values. Right. So this is equal, if you substitute the values of fc, so t is equal to, fc is given to be equal to what was the value of fc? Can anyone help me out? Yeah.
1/4 hertz.
Fc is 1/4 hertz, right? So okay, fc is one. So I'll write here, it is n pi plus pi by 2 divided by 2 pi times 1/4 hertz plus what is the value of kp? Kp is equal to pi by 2 and a is equal to 1. Right. So we will get, maybe I can write it as 2 n plus 1 pi by 2 only. Right. It would have been easier. 2 n plus 1 pi by 2 divided by, so this is actually what? 2 pi into 1/4 will be pi by 2 plus pi by 2. Right. So pi by 2 plus pi by 2, it is actually nothing but what? Pi. So we'll get 2 n plus 1 into if pi by 2 divided by pi. So this pi and pi will get cancelled. So we will get this to be equal to what? 2 n plus this is equal to, we'll get n plus 1/2, right? This pi and pi will get cancelled, right? So then 2n by 2 is n, sorry, and this 1/2 is as such. So when t is equal to n plus 1/2, right, where n is from 0, 1, it should be, yeah, no, 0, 1, 2, etc. up to infinity, right? Plus infinity, this is equal to, right, pm 0 closing will happen at these time instants, right? Pm 0 closings will happen at this time instance. You can see pm 0 closing interval will actually what increase as n increases, right? As n increases, the PM zero crossing will increase. So the first zero crossing will happen at n is equal to zero, right? First time it will cross zero when n is equal to zero at t equal to half, right? At t equal to half, first time zero crossing will happen. Second zero crossing will happen when n is equal to 1, right? Second zero crossing will happen when n is equal to 1. So that is t equal to 1.5. Third will happen at t equal to 2.5, right? So maybe let's just try whether we are getting this, right? Should we just try and simulate it and see whether what we got is correct? Should we try that? If you say yes, maybe we can try. Should we try or not? No response, right? So
okay, yes, sir.
Right. So for that, we should know what is S of T. S of T is, S of T was AC cos 2 pi FCT plus KP into AT, right? So if you substitute values here, AC is equal to 1, then cos 2 pi FC is 1 by 4, right? FC is 1 by 4. So if you substitute FC equal to 1 by 4 here, what will be this? 2 pi by 4, it will be pi by 2t. Pi by 2t plus kp is equal to pi by 2, right? Pi by 2 t plus kp is equal to actually what? Pi by 2, and a is equal to 1. So again, it will be actually what? Pi by 2 t. So this will be equal to cos pi t, right? So the resultant, right, signal will be equal to cos pi t. So if you simulate this, right, so what actually is the frequency of this? What actually frequency of this cos pi t? 2 pi f is equal to pi, right, which implies f is equal to pi by 2 pi, so that is equal to half, right? Same thing, what we got, frequency is half, right? So this cos pi t, right, if you try it out in GeoGebra, we should have zero crossings at half, 1.5, 2.5, etc., right? So we'll just try and see that whether it happens. Sorry, you have typed some messages in this. I was not able to see that. Why? Because I was in that PPT presentation mode, so I was not able to read. So some of you have typed some messages. Right. I couldn't see that. So whenever I'm presenting, I would request you to unmute yourself and tell. Right. That would be really great. So you see here. So now what is that we have to simulate? Cos of? What was the final expression? Cos pi t, right? Final expression was cos,
yes,
pi,
sir.
Right, cos pi t. This was the final expression. So what we did is with the given values, we simplified, right? So, and if you want, our message signal is, I'll show the message signal, that is AT. That will be like this, right? Message signal will be the red one, and our carrier signal is cos 2 pi into, again it is same thing, message signal and carrier signal both will be same. So I'm not showing the carrier. So you can see here, this is the right, so this is the
you can see message signal, it is this 80, right? That is the message signal. And if you see the modulated signal, you can see the zero crossing set, half, 1.5, 2.5. So what we have done is correct, right? Is it verified now? Right. So here, as m of t is linearly increasing, right, and this you can see our message signal cos 2 pi modulated signal cos 2 pi fct plus kp into m of t is cos pi t only, right? It's again actually what a sinusoid as such, right? The phase is linear, right? Phase is linear, right? Otherwise also phase will be actually what linearly increasing with respect to time, right? So here it is correct. So you can see the zero crossing set, half, 1.5, 2.5, etc. Now we'll see what happens for FM. So FM, we'll get some interesting results. So we'll see what happens for FM now, right? So for that, I'll present. So all of you, I believe all of you got what we have done now, right? All of you have an idea what we have done now, right? So what we have done is we some parameters are given for m of t is given, right? For that we have written the time domain expression for phase modulated signal, and we got some expression, and in that expression, from that expression we tried and found out at what instances of time we will get the zero crossings, right? So that is what we have done now. Now we will try the same thing for FM. Should we try it, or if I give it as a homework, will you be able to do? Now you can type it in chat window. I'm here only, right? So if you want me to try it, you can type yes. Otherwise, if you want to try it as a homework, that also would be fine. Whom should I ask? Yeah, no response. What does that mean? So I'll ask Savan. Savan, can you please unmute?
Yes, sir.
Do you want me to solve the part of the zero crossing of frequency modulation or not? Or you will try it on your own?
Yes, sir, could you try?
You will try it on your own.
No, sir. Could you try?
Yeah. Sure. Yeah. I'll do it for sure. Right. So now, right. Okay. Now, this is for PM what we have done so far. Now, we need actually what FM. So I will write in terms of KF and all those things. Right. So now, M of t is 80 for t greater than 0. I'm not considering the case when t less than 0. When t less than 0, it will be cosinusoid only. It will be the same, right? But this is 80 for t greater than 0, right? So now, what we have, what is s of t, fm? What is fm s of t? It is ac cos, can anyone tell me, cos 2 pi fct plus 2 pi kf into integral 0 to t m of tau d tau, right? So this is fm expression, right? Yes or no? Right, please give me some feedback. Right, so this is fm expression, right? Now what we'll do is we need integral 0 to tau t m of tau. So we'll find out that first. We'll find what is integral 0 to t m of tau d tau, right? So this is equal to integral 0 to t, right, a tau d tau, right? So what is a is a constant, so a came out, right? What is integral t or integral tau d tau or integral x dx? What is integral x dx? By seeing tau you don't get confused, right? It is equal to x square by 2, is it? Yes or no, please. Are you typing in something there in chat window? Yeah. So it is x square by 2, right? So I am asking not to test your knowledge. I seriously doubt, right? My basics are very poor, right? So if I make any mistake, please feel free to point out, right? So I think, yeah, it's fine. Now you say it is x square by 2. So this is equal to a cos square by 2. Right. So integral 0 to t. So a t square, a tau square by 2, and the limit are from 0 to t. Right. So if you apply the limit t, it is equal to a t square minus a into 0. Right. So it is a t square. Right. So this is equal to a t square by 2 is there, right? Sorry. A t square by 2. Is it correct what I have done?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you so much. Right. So now it is AC cos 2 pi FCT plus, now we have 2 pi KF into, I'll write it here, 2 pi KF into integral 0 to T M of tau d tau is equal to what? It is A T square by 2, right? So now this 2 and 2 will get cancelled, right? So what we have is AC cos 2 pi FCT plus pi KF A T square, pi KF AT square. So this is going to be a trouble. Why? Because we have T square and all. So we'll have to solve a quadratic equation. So okay, let us see. Right. So this is our S of T. Right. Now we should see when this will be equal to zero. Right. When this will be equal to zero. Again, this is cos. Cos of something will be equal to zero when, right, that something is odd multiple of pi by 2. Right. Same thing. Same thing what we have done. So it is equal to zero when S of t is equal to 0 when 2 pi FCT, 2 pi FCT plus pi KF into AT square, pi KF into AT square. Right. So I am not substituting values now itself because initially we are deriving the general expressions. Right. From there, finally, we are substituting the value. So these are general derivations. As a part of problem, I'm doing general derivations also. Please keep that in mind. So this is equal to n pi plus pi by 2. Or you can even write 2n plus 1 times pi by 2. Right. So where n is equal to 0, 1, 2, etc. Right. 2n plus 1 times pi by 2, where n is equal to 0, 1, 2, etc. Right. So now, what is, okay, maybe I will write it as 2n plus 1 pi by 2 only. So that now we have to solve this. We have to solve this entire thing, right? So what we have is pi kf at square plus 2 pi fc. So I'll pi kf into a times c square, 2 pi fc times t, right? Then minus of 2n plus 1 times pi by 2, this is equal to 0, right? This is a quadratic equation. Now we have to solve for t, right? How to solve for t? Can anyone help me out how to solve for t? So normally whenever I used to get such problems, I used to keep on staring at the problem, right? And I will never used to take my pen, right? I used to keep on staring at the problem and I never used to get answer. But if such problems are coming, especially, right, I'll tell some problems in like this, and maybe some problems in control system and all. We say block diagram reduction, or maybe that Ruth Hurwitz criteria with many very high power and all. Right. My problem was I even though I knew the method, right, I used to stare at that, and that staring never used to give me answers. So what you should do is, right, if someone has a habit of staring at problems, right, please forget that. Take your pen and paper and start writing it. Right. So it is a quadratic equation of the form ax square plus bx plus c. Right. So here a is equal to what? Pi kf into a. Right. So please don't confuse this a with that a. Maybe, right, I'll use it capital A. Capital ax square plus bx plus c. So capital A is equal to this much. Right. capital B is equal to 2 pi fc, capital C is equal to minus 2 pi 2n plus 1 times pi by 2, right? So now what is t, right? What is x? If this is the quadratic equation, what is x? X will be equal to, you know, minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac all divided by 2a. Do we have any name for this equation? I forgot. Right. Equation to find this root of a quadratic equation. Do we have any name for this equation? Anybody knows? Okay, fine. So now we'll just call it the equation to find root of quadratic right equation. Fine. So now if you substitute this here, so x, so now in this case t is equal to minus b. Minus b is actually what? Minus 2 pi fc, right? Minus 2 pi fc, right? Plus or minus square root of b square is actually b square again. 2 pi fc the whole square, right? Minus 4 times a is pi kf into a, right? Pi kf into a, 4a times c, right? C is minus 2n plus 1 pi by 2. So that minus n minus, it will become plus. I'm just writing here plus, right? Times 2n plus 1 times pi by 2, this entire thing under root, right? So even though it is a little bit lengthy, right, it's not complicated. Only thing which can refrain us from getting a solution is our laziness, right? So divided by 2a, 2 times pi kf into a, right? So this is what we have. Now can anyone simplify it and tell, you substitute the values of fc, right? And we will consider only actually what, this positive root, right? The positive root we will consider, right? So can anyone like simplify this and give me an answer, please? Can anyone simplify this and give me an answer? Right, so maybe I can do that, right? So you can try it out later. So as it's already 9:50, right? So you can simplify it. So how, if you simplify this, 2 pi and 2 pi in this first term will get cancelled, right? Minus fc by ka will be there. So this t, or normally we can call tn, right? Tn, t will, we need to find actually what, t for different values of n, right? Tn, it will be equal to 1 by AKF, right? 1 by AKF into, say, this, if you simplify this, okay, 2 pi, if you take outside, 1 by AKF into, right? Then say, you can try it out, minus FC plus, this is root of, right? So if you take this 2 pi common and take it out, so we will get FC square plus AKF into half plus n, right? If you solve this, you will get, right, now I have just noted it down, copied it down from the textbook, right? So you will get this for sure, right, with n equal to 0, 1, 2, right? So this is tn, right? This is tn, right? Now if you substitute the value of a, kf, everything, right, if you substitute the value of a is equal to 1, kf is equal to pi by 2, so kf is equal to again 1, right? Kf is again 1, right? But fc is equal to 1 by 4, right? And if you simplify that, we will get 1 by 4 minus 1 plus only right, plus root of 9 plus 16, and you substitute all the values which are given, right? You substitute
FC is equal to 1 by 4, A is equal to 1, KF is equal to 1, right? So then you will get this, right? Tn is equal to 1 by 4 into minus 1 plus root of 9 plus 16 n, right? So this is what we will get for Fm, right? This zero closing time of Fm. So this is a zero closing time of Fm, right? So if you see this, right, maybe as n increases, right, as n increases, it's actually what, maybe if you take this minus out, it's, right, so these, if you take this minus, so what happens as n increases, what will happen to this? This will also increase, but the problem is, right, the spacing between the zero crossings will be less. The spacing between zero crossings will be less as n increases. But how can we visualize that? Is there any idea how to visualize this? Right, one option is, right, one option of actually what, writing the expression for this s of t, right, writing the expression for s of t and visualizing it, right, that I'll give it to you as an activity, right? So I'm not telling it as a homework. What you do is you just write this time domain expression in GeoGebra, right? Put the value fc equal to 1 by 4, kf is equal to 8, a, everything you put, right? I'm not doing it for fm, for pm I've shown it, right? For fm, should I show it, or maybe I'll give it as a homework? Maybe what we'll do is we'll just try and simulate only the zero crossing time. So it is, anyone please note down this, and you have to help me out in typing it in GeoGebra. It is Tn equal to 1 by 4 into minus 1 plus root of 9 plus 16n. Right, or else you can even write root of 9 plus 16n minus 1 times 1 by 4. So I'll just, right, so please note it down. I'll just show it in GeoGebra, and after that we'll just have our regular quiz and wind up our session. Right. I'll just in a moment I'll finish this. So only idea is what happens for PM, right? When it was a linear voltage, right, phase was changing linearly, the zero crossing was, right, regular. So maybe I'll just, so what was that? It was 1 by 4. Can anyone help me out with that expression? 1 by 4 times
root minus, 9 plus 16.
Minus, yeah, minus 1 plus,
right, root 9 plus 16.
Yeah, okay. 1 by 4 plus root of, square root of, right, I'll, 9 plus
16.
16 n, right? So now what I want is, I want it as my, say, x, I'll show only the point. So for that I can define it as a point, right? For that, this part will be my x coordinate, right, and my y coordinate will be equal to 0. My y coordinate will be equal, now I have defined a point with x coordinate equal to this and y coordinate as 0. So I can see these points, right, I can see these points on my x-axis. That is what I am. I think, right. Now, I'll define my n from, say, 0 to, we'll take n from 0 to 100. First 100, right. And interval of 1, right, at interval of 1. Now, what I'll do is for you to just visualize, I'll just show the trace. Where, however it moves. So now I'm going to simulate it, right? Oh, it didn't change, I'm sorry. N is, say, 0. Okay, N is 0 to 100 at steps of 1, right? Right, now I'll just simulate it. Just see how it moves. Right. These will be the points of zero crossing. Are you able to visualize it?
So
right.
So maybe I'll just reduce the speed a bit. Are you able to see? Right. So first zero will happen at 0.5, then at 1, then somewhere here. Then you can see the frequency is increasing, right? As right, n increases, right, the frequency, as time progresses, frequency will be increasing. So you will be able to what? So if you are able to plot an FM wave, right? If you are able to plot an FM wave, right? So you will get a sinusoid with constant magnitude, but the zero crossings will happen. First zero crossing will happen at 0.5, second one at somewhere at 1, then here, right? Should we see that also? Maybe you can try it out. So what is the inference from this, what we have seen? You can see, right, when m of t is equal to at, which is actually what, with time, magnitude is linearly increasing of the message signal, then the frequency is also actually what, increasing, right? Frequency is increasing. If frequency is increasing, spacing between zero crossings will reduce, right? That is what we are seeing here, right? So if you can plot this, if you can plot the FM, so I'll give as an exercise, right? It's not compulsory. Those who really want to visualize, those who want to verify, you can just plot the time domain expression in this GeoGebra, right? So that's it. So with that, right, we will end today's session. So Savan, he has given a thumbs up. Thank you, Savan. Right. I don't know why he has given thumbs up. Savan, is it for like verifying the result or for ending the session at time?
No, sir. You told that to note down that in this one. That's me.
Okay. Yeah. Fine. Right. Okay. Yeah. So that's it. Right. Today's session. Today, I'm not keeping a quiz. Right. But I'll keep. Whenever I am discussing something which you really want to what take forward, at that time, even if I spend 20 minutes, I'll conduct a quiz. I just want to make sure you people are listening. Right. So today we tried and verify the zero crossing time, right? That property we have seen, and we solved a problem, right? So is it clear how we solve this problem, zero crossing time? It's very simple. What you have to do is, you have to just write the time domain expression, and if it is cause of something, right? So when cause of something will be zero, that something should be odd multiples of pi by 2. So equate it to odd multiples of pi by 2, solve for t, you will get something that will be the instance of zero crossing. So then first zero crossing will happen at n is equal to 0, second will happen at n equal to 2, 3, so on and so forth, right? So that's what we have done, and we have even seen. So even right, I wanted to show FM simulation as well. Should I show that? Simply one FM simulation. I already have circuit. So if you would permit, right, I'll take 2 minutes. Just I'll show the FM wave, a message signal and FM wave. Or else, no need.
Okay, right. Sir.
No need. Anyhow, it is Navaratri and all, right? So I should not simply prolong it. Maybe I can share it. I'll put it in Canvas. You can try it out, right? So I'll put the link in Canvas. You can try out, right? So okay, that's it. So that's it for today, right? And thank you so much, right? Thank you so much for joining in. If you have any doubt, you may please ask, right? Otherwise, you can. If I ask something, if you don't respond properly, right, what will happen? Yesterday, I ended up in a blunder, right? Maybe if you ask Prajwal, Prajwal is there? Prajwal and team?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.